Dr. Centeno, and I'd like to talk about the difference between various types of stem cell procedures and products, because this is super confusing and clinics out there make it even more confusing. So it's almost impossible as a patient to figure this stuff out. So I've been researching the use of stem cells in orthopedics for a decade and a half, and in that time I've authored many scientific papers and book chapters, so I have a little bit of sense of what I'm talking about here. And one of the things that drives me crazy is when I see doctors who don't know what they don't know try to compare different cell types that are really apples and oranges. And one of the biggest scams out there is doctors who tout stem cell research that use stem cell type A, and they're talking about research on stem cell type A, but they're really offering stem cell type B. So it's a bit of consumer fraud. And you've got to protect yourself and get educated as a consumer, or you're going to get scammed. So we can divide all of these stem cell therapies into three types. Same day autologous, which is your cells, allogeneic, someone else's cells, and culture expanded stem cells. So for autologous same day, meaning your cells, we basically have bone marrow and fat stem cell type therapies. These are live stem cells. And for allogeneic or someone else's cells, we have amniotic and umbilical cord. These are dead stem cells. And both of these cell therapy types have some stem cells mixed in with many, many other cells. So that includes the same day autologous bone marrow and fat and the allogeneic amniotic umbilical cord. Again, recognizing that the amniotic umbilical cord stuff, that's all dead cells. The research is clear on that now. If that's a surprise to you, then watch some of my other videos. Then we've got culture expanded stem cells. These aren't legal in the US. They can be made from bone marrow, fat, or umbilical cord cells. And these cells are isolated and grown to bigger numbers, so you tend to get a much more pure stem cell population. And this is a completely different animal than either of the prior cell therapy types I've described. And these are live stem cells as well. Now, the big problem is we often see clinics that use one type of cell therapy, but again, provide research papers on another. A common bait and switch shell game right now is a clinic that uses dead umbilical cord stem cells and discusses research papers using live culture expanded umbilical cord stem cells. Again, two completely different things. One has nothing to do with the other as far as clinical results. So I hope you learned a little bit today. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.